Welcome to the second of four videos introducing the Weather Project in Physical Geography. In this video, we will look at your thermometer setup. Your thermometer is first affected by regional temperature and then tweaked by the microclimate where you have it set up. As you plan your setup, consider how the things around your thermometer will affect the temperature. Consider the heat capacity of the surrounding materials and the time of day you take the reading. Recall that high heat capacity materials, such as things with a lot of water in them, like vegetation, do not change temperature quickly, while low heat capacity materials, such as asphalt, wood, and concrete, change temperature quickly. Let's first review how the time of day affects the temperature. This is the hourly weather graph generated by the National Weather Service for Los Altos Hills in late April. Notice that the gray areas indicate the time of day in which it is dark. Notice that the temperature is lowest at sunrise and in the early morning, and climbs throughout the day, peaking in the late afternoon. Let's apply this to an example setup in my backyard. First, notice that the dark colored plastic chair that I have propped the thermometer on has a low albedo and low heat capacity, so it will heat up quickly. Because of this, I keep the chair in the shade until it is time to take the temperature reading. Then I put the chair and the thermometer out for about 5 minutes. The grass and surrounding vegetation has a lot of water in it, so it will keep things at a more moderate temperature. However, the wooden fence and the house that enclose the backyard restrict airflow. So the result of all this is that at night and in the early mornings, I would expect the temperature in my backyard to be warmer than the National Weather Service because of the vegetation and the restricted airflow. In the late afternoon, it would be warmer as well because of the chair heating up and the restricted airflow. However, the temperature will not be much higher than the Weather Service. If I had a lot more vegetation or it was located in the shade, it might even be a little cooler than the Weather Service reading, again because of the vegetation. The restricted airflow and low heat capacity, low albedo materials overall create a heat island effect in my backyard. Next, let's look at a car in a parking lot. This car is parked on a low albedo, low heat capacity asphalt. The area is open, so there is no restriction of airflow. Overall, we would expect this area to be somewhat cooler than the National Weather Service in the early mornings because of the low heat capacity materials, but much warmer than the National Weather Service in the late afternoon because of the low heat capacity, low albedo materials, which heat up quickly. That's it for this video. The next short video will introduce you to the data collection discussion and the class dataset. Happy trails!